Good evening. This is Uncle Yab, and we're gabbing with Yab. And today, we're talking about the new norm as far as the holidays. I have my co-host here, Richard Carrington. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great, man. You?
Good. I'm doing good. All right. So we talked the other day about having a vaccine and things like that, and that came out, and a lot of people were concerned with it. But now, today, we're going to talk about the new norm for the holiday.
Yes.
So as far as the new norm for the holiday, what I think is going to be is, like I said before, probably next week, we're going to have the vaccine coming out for certain areas of the hospital.
Right.
And they say it's not going to be mandatory, which is a good thing.
Right.
But for the holidays, what's going to probably happen is we're going to still be social distancing. And we can't have any big parties for Christmas and stuff like that. So
right.
If you guys, you know, if you've been listening to the news and stuff like that, please pay attention to that. Make sure you keep a small gathering and you still can, you know, do your Christmas holidays and open up your gifts and eat and stuff like that.
Right.
But make sure it's just a small amount of people.
Yeah. No, I agree, man. You know, we have to, like you said, it's a new norm, you know, and you know, the holiday season is very important, and, you know, it's a time where, you know, we get together with family and loved ones, and, you know, it's important to some people, like, you know, like, for instance, my mother, man, you know, this
right.
is like her big season, you know, she loves Thanksgiving, she goes all out for Thanksgiving and Christmas,
right.
you know.
Right, right.
When I was a kid, she worked, you know, extra jobs, you know, get on the train and bus late at night just so she could have stuff, you know.
Gotcha.
Because no
gotcha.
Matter, you know, some people don't celebrate Christmas or whatever, but whatever
right.
you do,
mm-hmm.
during this season, you're more friendly, you know, people are more jolly, people are nicer to each other, you know, they're doing swaps at work, you
exactly.
know.
Exactly, you're right.
Yankee swaps and secret mm-hmm. Santas and stuff
mm-hmm.
like that. And so, you know, it's a time where, like I said, no matter what you religion you are or if you're a religion or not, you know, it's a time where people, you know, they say, what do they say? 'Tis the season to be jolly.
Exactly.
So, you know, for some people, it's a change, you know. And, you know, because I thought about that. I was thinking about my mom, man, you know, because this was like her time, you know. And she's used to, you know, everybody coming over and the
yep.
kids opening the toys
I
and all that stuff. And it's
I understand
different,
that.
You know?
You're right.
It's a new normal.
Yep. Especially for me. My family's not even here. We talked about that before in our prior
right.
podcast. So.
Right.
For me to even try to go home, is I can't do that.
Right.
You know, so I was talking to my sister, and my sister, she keeps my mother, because my mom has dementia. But
okay.
we are big in family with
yes.
the Christmas and stuff like that.
Right.
We always have Christmas.
Yeah.
And then we'll go over somebody's house for Christmas brunch.
Right,
and we'll
right.
eat, you know,
right.
open up gifts and
yeah,
stuff like
man.
That, man.
Yeah.
And it's all a big fun in the family.
Yeah.
But now, since this pandemic has hit, nobody want to do nothing.
No, man, no. And, you know, because people are scared. And, you know, and then,
mm-hmm.
you know, the guidance we're getting is that, you know, shouldn't be more than a certain number of people.
Right.
And, you know, it's all adjusting to this new thing, you know, this new way of life. And, like, you know, we were saying the new norm. But, you know, when you think about it, you know, I think about, you know, as a kid, you know, what the holidays meant to me now as opposed
right.
to,
right.
you know. But my kids have... You know, it's different now.
Yeah,
you know?
That's true.
And we have to accept it, you know.
Yeah, yeah, I'm the same way. What we doing now, as far as me and my girlfriend and everything like that, we got the house done, and
yeah.
we still kind of festive.
Yeah.
And we got the tree up, and we got all the presents wrapped and things like
right.
that. But in a sense, it's still kind of different
yeah,
because
yeah,
we're not expecting a big crowd.
Right.
And she has a pretty decent sized family, but me myself, I have a large family.
Right, yeah.
And as of right now, no one of my immediate family is up here, with
right.
the exception of my two daughters and stuff like yeah. that. But, you know, not to say it's hard for me, but back, you know, I'm looking back in the day when I was a kid and I
yeah.
was coming up, we
yeah.
did all of that.
Yeah,
we went to people's houses.
It was a special time, yeah.
We received gifts, did mm-hmm. like you said, did a secret Santa.
Yeah.
And there's everybody looking forward to the holidays. And I'm not trying to discourage anybody out there, but just do the best you can and have a good time, because it's always next year,
yeah.
you know, 2021.
That's right.
And we can start this over again.
That's
and,
right.
Hopefully we can have a better Christmas and everybody can start getting outside and getting to a more normal part of the way we live
right.
versus now. And it's weird now. It's a weird time.
Right. I mean, it's a time where, you know, we're going to have to sacrifice so that we can have the better later. You know what I'm saying? We got to sacrifice this
That's
year.
True.
We got to, you know, yeah, you know, you want to be able to do everything, but not sacrifice, you know. And you know, things change over, you know, over time, but you can still do, you know, people do Zoom.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
oh, yeah.
And they can celebrate Zoom and celebrate Christmas on Zoom with family members, and you can still, you know, send gifts to people if that's what you like to do.
That's true. And that's what I'm doing, too. I have kids down in Georgia that I'm sending gifts to, like I've been doing.
Right.
And my sister was saying something about the Zoom thing.
Yeah.
And I'm going to see if she's really going to, hold her to her word as far as that's concerned.
Yeah.
And just to see everybody's face.
Yeah, it works,
as much
man.
As you can. Yeah, have you done a Zoom before?
Yeah, yeah. I do, you know, some for, like with the family. Like my cousin just had a birthday last week and his wife set it up. So,
oh, really?
You know, like, because he's in Ohio and, you know, his kids are in Rhode Island. One of his daughters in Rhode Island.
Oh, okay, okay.
And, you know, his mother's here, you know, my mother. So we were all on the call, wished him happy birthday.
Gotcha,
and
gotcha.
Even people from Virginia and Alabama were on the call. So it was fun to kind of see all the people and, you know, people going back and forth, talking about sports, you know.
So how many people you can get on a Zoom call at one time?
I think you could probably get about 20 or 30 people, man.
Really?
Yeah, because the screen it'll break down and get smaller. You can see some people don't, like, put their face on it. But,
oh, yeah, yeah.
You know, and, you know, maybe that's what it is, you know, this year.
So everybody got to have a connection, right?
Yeah.
As far as, you know,
yeah, like
Zoom.
A Wi-Fi.
It's an app, right?
Yeah. Zoom. But you can download it. It's free. You know?
I get you.
So, you know, because, like I said, my mother's 76, and she does it, you know?
Yeah.
And it just takes a few minutes to learn, and then, you know, it... It's a different. It's really the new normal, man.
That's true. That's what we're talking about, right?
Exactly, because we're all not going to be able to be in the same room and, you know, have the big spread out.
Right.
So this is kind of like part of that new normal, you know. And, you know, a lot of companies do it. Like my wife does it for her meetings at work and stuff.
Okay.
They do like the Zoom or.
Right.
They got other ones, but, you know, the Zoom ones, I think, is a big popular one, so.
Yeah, but I'm thinking about doing it, man. I'm going to get my sister together, and if, you know, it'll be like maybe before we eat or after we eat, we'll get people on and say, hey, how you doing? Merry Christmas. I haven't seen you guys in a long time. You guys looking good or whatever.
Yeah.
Stay safe.
Right.
You know.
And then at least you make contact, you know, with some people. So, you know, it's just... Like you said, we're here, you know, it's different here. We're not going to have those celebrations we have at work like we used to.
Right, right.
You know, I mean, they may order something, but it's not. It's a different day.
It is.
And we have to accept that not only do we have to wear masks, but we have to adjust our lives to what is this new normal, you know?
That's right. And a lot of people, I think for the most part, people, they are in agreeance as to what's going on and what's going to be coming down the pike. And a lot of people are just used to it, saying, okay, if this is what we got to do, this is what we got to do.
Yeah.
You know, but since we got the vaccine coming along, a lot of people are saying, you know what, hey, I'm going to take a chance and I'll do this.
Yeah.
You know, whether something may be against their moral value.
Right.
A lot of people just anxious to get back to normal.
Yeah.
They want to get back to seeing their family. They want to get back to traveling. Because I know for a fact I haven't been anywhere outside of the area that we live in.
Right.
You know, and I like to go down south and everything like that, but I haven't been able to do any of that.
Yeah.
Just for the sake of just, you know, me being protective of myself.
Yeah. And we have to, man. You know, if we want to try to get rid of this thing, get it under control, because, you know, they're saying it's back, you know, higher than it was back in, I think, in June or something.
June, yeah.
And that, you know, I think the governor rolled back some stuff where we can't, like, they're closing churches again on Sunday. And
other
places will not be able to open.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, if we get used to the new normal and we, you know, adjust to it and just accept it.
Right.
I think things will be better. You know what I mean?
That's true.
You know?
And then when it does go back to normal, it won't be like a big shock.
Right.
We'll be like, oh, okay, we always wanted this.
Right.
So we can just keep on moving. Yeah. But right now, as it is today, you know, wearing a mask and we keeping the social distancing, that's what we got to do.
Yeah.
You know, and like, once again, I have no problem with it. And I just hopefully everybody out there in podcast land will do the same and adhere to what your states and what your cities are putting down as far as what you guys need to be doing.
It's important,
man. And don't be afraid to, you know, voice your opinion and stuff like that. But for the most part, we want everybody out there to be safe and to take care of each other and take care of your family.
Right. And just realize that, you know, you can still have a great time. You can still show love.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just we're doing it in a different way, you know, this year. And, you know, it's nothing to be sad about. It's just that's the reality of the world, you know, that we live in.
That's true. That's true.
And so we should just, you know, adjust, like I said, and take it in, man. You
know? Yeah. And be thankful.
Yes.
Because
we're always going to be thankful.
That's true. That's true. You because it's always going to be, hopefully, there's going to be other Christmases.
Yes.
So don't think because you can't do what you want to do now. You know, it's always 2021, and we all now we're looking forward to 2021 to see what the, you know, that year brings. And so far, you know, as far as the January 20th is concerned, we have the inauguration and things like that. So a lot of things, a lot of different changes and turn of events is going to happen pretty soon.
Yes.
You know, but we definitely looking forward to this this the coronavirus and the COVID-19 to at least get under control some kind of way so we can just live normal again.
Yeah.
You know, and but it is what it is. I'm still here. You still here.
Still here, brother.
You know, the families are safe.
Yes.
And that's all we can ask for, right?
And we're going to do, we're going to celebrate the best we can through this holiday season, you know?
That's right. Yeah. And just letting you guys know, I'm trying to do a video thing now. I got my camera out and we're rolling with that.
Yes.
So give me some time to get that up and about. That'll all be on my YouTube channel. And I have a YouTube channel, which is the same thing. Uncle Yab, and my YouTube is Gab with Yab.
Yes.
And you guys can listen to my podcast audio, and now you can see me video too. So
yes.
I'm trying to do things big, and if anybody have any you know questions, anybody wants to come on the show and talk, we can do that because I'm trying to take this to another level.
Yeah, and I know you said you want people, if they have some topics they want us to cover.
Oh, yeah.
You know, we'll take suggestions.
That's right. If you guys want to get in touch with me, you can email me, you can give me a call. If you guys know who I am, you guys know how to reach me.
Yes.
And we can turn this thing into something special.
All right,
Rich, you got anything else to say?
No, man, just looking forward to the holiday season, brother.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
And I'll just, you know, just let everybody know Merry Christmas out there and Happy New Year.
Same.
This is Uncle Yab, and we're gabbing with Yab. Good night.
Good night.